The purpose of this video is to show you how to use the Breakout Rooms feature in Microsoft Teams. So just to clarify, the Breakout Rooms feature is different than the Channels feature, because Channels is when you create separate channels in your Teams tile so that your students can go into a small group channel and they can meet in a small group. That requires the student to leave the main meeting and go into the channel meeting or the small group meeting. The difference with Breakout Rooms is that in the main session, you can split the kids up into smaller sessions without them having to click out of the meeting, and then you can bring them back. It's very similar to the Zoom Breakout Rooms. I do want to give a disclaimer. I have been playing around with this for a few days. It's a new feature. The only time I seem to have the Breakout Rooms icon is when I create a meeting through Outlook or when I go into the calendar on my Teams app and then I hit Meet Now. I have not had the Breakout Room feature be available to me when I'm in my tile and when I do a meeting through my Teams tile. So again, I've only had this icon be available to me either through Outlook when I create a meeting link in Outlook or when I create a meeting link or Meet Now in the Teams calendar. I'm not sure why this is, but I did want to give a disclaimer. But again, the purpose of this video is to show you how to use the Breakout Rooms feature, and hopefully you will have it where you need it. So anyways, if you look at your tile, or I'm sorry, if you look at your toolbar in your meeting, you'll notice there should be this icon. It's got four squares and they're connected to the biggest square by lines. If you hover over that, it says Breakout Rooms. So if I click on Breakout Rooms, it's going to ask me for some information. It's going to say, how many rooms do you need? This would really depend on how many small groups you're planning on having. For the purpose of this video, I'm gonna put two rooms, but you have a lot of options. You can meet in groups of three, you could have the kids doing partner work, there's a lot you could do. So this is where you would select how many small groups is this meeting breaking up into. The next thing you can do is decide, do you want Teams to automatically assign the kids, which means they'll be randomly assigned, or do you want to manually assign the kids to Breakout Rooms? I always choose manually so that I can choose which kids are going with which group and which teacher. But you'll do what works for you. Once you select how many rooms and you select how the kids will be split up, you can hit Create Rooms. And keep in mind, I'm in a meeting with somebody, so you'll be creating these Breakout Rooms once your kids get into the meeting. So you'll need all of your kids in the meeting, and then you can split them up into these rooms. So this might be a good time maybe to give them like a 5-minute break so that you can just set the rooms up, and then when they get back, you can put them into small groups. So once we did that, it pulls this up on the side. Again, I only have one participant, but it's gonna ask me to assign her. So if I select her name and I hit assign, it's gonna ask me, do I wanna put her in room one or room two? So for the purpose of this video, I'll put her in room one. And then I don't have any more students, or else I would put them in room two. But once I've split the students up into the rooms, and remember we just did that by assigning them, I would be ready to start my rooms. If I needed to add another room, maybe I forgot I needed three groups instead of two, I could just hit add room and add another Breakout Room. But for the purpose of this video, I'm only doing two. So anyways, I am gonna go ahead and I am going to start the rooms. So I'm gonna click the start button. It's opening the room for my student that I put in there. And now it's open. So you're gonna notice in a second, her icon is gonna disappear because it's gonna put her in her own separate room. And you'll notice that there's nobody in the second room, so it didn't open. But if you had students in that second room, it would. So as you can see now, I'm by myself. I sent that student to breakout room one. So currently that student is in a room by herself. And obviously if I was doing small groups, I would maybe have her in there with an ESP or a resource teacher. I just wanted to demonstrate it to you. So right now that student's doing independent work in that small room, and I can either be here meeting with the kids who I didn't assign, or I have the option to go check on that student in small group one. So if I highlight the room that she's in, if I hit the three dots, it gives me the option to join the room. So if I hit join room, it's gonna take me into that room with that student. Here she is. So now I'm able to work with her in small group one while my other students are either in another breakout room or they're in the whole group meeting. I know it sounds a little confusing, but just think of it as if you were in your own classroom and you were breaking students up into different areas of your classroom. That's sort of the concept here. So when you're ready to leave the breakout room, and you'll notice this says room one. I'm in room one with the student, but the main session is still open for me. It's just on hold. So if I'm done with my small group with this student, I would just leave room one and then I would resume the whole group session. And if I'm ready to bring the students back from the breakout rooms, I would click on the breakout rooms icon. And where it says close rooms, I would just hit close rooms. It's gonna close those breakout rooms and bring that student back to my main session. So we'll give it a second for her to come back. It might take a couple seconds, and here she is. So now we are back in the original main session that we started in. The student didn't have to do anything. She didn't need to click out of anything. She didn't need to go into a channel. I was able to split her up into her own breakout group on Teams. So that is the purpose of the breakout rooms feature. So again, I know it might have been a bit overwhelming if this was a lot of information. Just keep in mind, do what works best for you. If you're using channels and that works better for you, definitely keep doing that. And I have a video on channels you can go see. If you want to try the breakout rooms, you can always try them by just clicking on that breakout rooms icon and then assigning the kids into rooms and hitting start rooms. And when you're ready to bring the kids back, you would hit close rooms. So if you have any questions, please drop a comment below. This is a very new feature from Teams, so there still are a few things that might need to be improved or worked out, but it is a great feature. It should make things a lot easier on your students and on your assistants or ESPs. I hope this video was helpful. Again, leave a comment if you have a question.